Hey, and welcome back to Data Mining with Azure Machine Learning Studio, brought to you by Data Science Dojo. Today, we're going to go and learn how to drop or remove columns or features from our dataset. When you have features that may lead the model astray or features that the model don't know how to work with, like text or image data, dropping them becomes very necessary to guide the model's learning. Now, dropping columns will also speed up the efficiency of the operations, especially within Azure ML, since every time you notice when we run the every time we run an execution module, it goes ahead and caches that next data set in its own module on a separate computer. Okay, so it makes our payloads lighter and it speeds up our workflow by shedding those columns that we don't need. But you want to make sure that those columns that we're dropping do indeed add no value in their current forms, because we want the model to learn from as much data that it can have access to. Okay. And let's go ahead and get started. So two videos ago, I did some data exploration, and then we identified columns that would not add value to our machine learning model in its current form. Now, if you want to hear my rationale on why we're dropping these particular columns in this iteration, go ahead and watch that video. It's called Data Exploration. And we did it about two videos. And this is the list that I ended up with. So notice I have a list of columns I want to drop, like quarter, month, day of the week, et cetera, et cetera. Not that these columns aren't useful, they're just not useful right now in their current form. Okay, so I'm going to show you three different methods, three different ways to drop columns from Azure ML. They're three different ways that do the same thing, but they approach it differently. And there might be times where one is more optimal than the other. All right, so let's go into that. So you want to search in your toolbox, you want to search for a module called Select Columns, okay? Select Columns. So I will drag in the Select Columns in dataset module, and I will connect it directly after my join. So after I've joined all of my datasets together in the last video, I will join, I will then output the output of that join. So this table that now has six extra columns on it, it will now be thrown into the Select Columns module, okay? So the Select Columns module will let me decide if I launch this column selector. So there's three ways, okay? So the first way is this window pops up right here, okay? So this window will only pop up if there is a green checkbox in the previous module, okay? If there's not a green checkbox in the previous module, what you wanna do is you wanna hover over this, you wanna select the module, that is the dependency. You want to hover over run and then hit the run selected. So it's going to go ahead and run everything up until this module. Okay, so it needs to have a green checkbox for you to see this particular window where you have available columns and selected columns. Okay, so this is the first method, which is you have this column. Okay, so what this column does is you select the column names that you want to keep and throw them into the selected column side. So you can either do, you can throw the columns you want to keep onto the right side, for example, one at a time, right? Or what you can do is you can select all, say you want to start with every column and then start by dropping a particular column. So I'm going to start doing that real quick. So in this case, year, quarter, month, and I think day of the month is something that I want to leave behind. So these are the columns that are being left behind right now. Okay, because I have airport name in the last join for both the origin and the destination, I no longer need both the origin and the destination airport ID, so I can drop those now. Okay, so let's go back to this too. So it also says I should drop CRS departure time and CRS arrival time. So let's go ahead and do that real quick. So CRS arrival time, I'm gonna hold down the shift button so I can select multiple things. So CRS arrival time and CRS departure time. So I'm holding down the control button. That's how I'm selecting multiple things at the same time. And then I can go ahead and tell that I want to leave these columns behind. Okay. And then I think that's it. Now remember, we have four response classes. Okay. And we only want to keep one response class. So that's the arrival delay 15. Okay. So we want this to be an easy classification machine learning problem. So I'm going to go ahead and go and find arrival delay, leave that behind. I'm also going to leave behind the arrival, nope, the the canceled and the diverted columns. I want to leave those behind too. So these are the columns I'm gonna be left for going forward. So I'm gonna leave behind 11 columns. Basically, these are the columns that I'm dropping, and I'm gonna bring forward 13 columns. I'm gonna go ahead and hit this run button now. So notice that once I've hit the run button, there is a list of columns that I'm gonna keep inside of the launch column selector. Okay. So the output of this column in the datasets will be another dataset. It will be cached within this module, and it should have, if we did it right, it should have much less columns than it had before. So it should have 13 columns if we look at it this way. Okay, so here we are. So that's one method, which is we had a window where we selected which columns we wanted to keep and which columns we wanted to leave behind. Let me show you another method. So I'm going to copy this select columns in datasets module, and then I'm going to drag it over here. So I'm also going to show you that it's just a parallel workflow. It does the same thing. Okay, so it's up to you which one you want to keep. I'm just showing you an alternate method. Okay, so let's say you had thousands of columns, right? That could be a problem sometimes, right? You don't want to specify individual columns that you want to keep one at a time. Maybe there's 1,000 columns and you only want to drop 4 of them. Okay, so here's a way to do that. So if you launch the column selector, you can filter columns by name, right? That's what we did last time, or we can do it by rules. So on the left side, there is by rules or by names. Okay, so with rules, there's two modes. I can begin with no columns selected, and then I can add individual columns to this list, for example. So notice that I can X these out or I can add them in, okay? The secondary method I can do is I want to say, okay, begin with all columns. Begin with all columns, and then instead of saying include, I would say exclude, okay? All right, so I want to begin with all of the columns, so 13 plus 11, and then these are the particular columns that I'm about to list to be excluded, okay? So I'm going to exclude name, year, quarter, month, day of the month. I think we're going to drop also, you get the idea. So that's the secondary method of doing it, okay? I'm going to delete this for less confusion, and then I'm going to document what this is doing. So in the select columns, I'm going to say this is dropping columns, okay? And then I'm going to expand it. Okay, and that's how you drop columns in Azure ML. So join us next time, and I'll show you how to clean missing values from our data set and also how to get summary statistics out of our data set. Hey, if you liked that video and you want to see more videos like this in the future, go ahead and like and subscribe, and I will look forward to seeing you at our boot camp.